And as you can see, it is very nice sunshine. Today, it's very nice. This is all the natural lighting. There is no lights or anything turned on. So in continuation from my yesterday's mukbang video, I said I almost forgot to buy the fizzy water, and I bought the fizzy water. And now, this morning, I realized I forgot to buy ketchup, because the ketchup is a few drops left only. It's like, you can never win. It's like, whatever. So right now, just using the roommate's ketchup. And so, now for today's breakfast, it is these hash browns, which Matthew made, and I'm really annoyed the way he made it. And this omelet.
What's
wrong? And bacon. I'll get into that a little bit later, why I'm annoyed. And so let's get going with this today, guys. And so for this brand of this ketchup, the yellow label, we never really shop there because we don't like it there. Our roommate shops there, so we don't shop there. And yeah. Because, like, you know, like, when you go into a store sometimes and you can just feel the weird vibes or something that the place lets out and stuff like that. And it's just, I don't like it at all, so I don't go. Yeah, we haven't gone there for years, and so, yeah. So about these hash browns, I am very mad because Matthew, again, just like the last time with the sorry looking potatoes like last time, and a few of you guys agreed as well that they looked very sorry. And so I am mad because I was expecting Matthew to pan fry the shredded hash browns, and then Matthew used the air fryer. And I was really looking forward to it because I really, really like the hash browns that they serve at Denny's. I really, really, really like that. And so we haven't gone to Denny's in a long time either. It's one of those places like that. And I like the how crispy and golden color that the Denny's makes the hash brown all the time like that. And it's so aromatic, the hash browns. Not like this one. And so that's why it makes me so mad. Like, look at this. Like, seriously. But these are shredded hash browns. It's one of my favorite hash browns as well. Besides the taters. So I like to switch it up once in a while. So this is what it looks like up close. The shredded hash browns. And they just sell them in the frozen section near where the potatoes are, the french fries. I remember when I showed a video about this long time ago when I did a shopping haul or something and I bought this shredded hash browns. One of you guys said that you've never seen this type of hash browns or something before in your country, and I do not exactly remember what country that is, but yeah, I remember getting a comment like that. And when Matthew made the omelet today, it's sort of like sticky. Can you guys see that? It's sort of a little bit sticky looking. But that is still better than the way that I make hash omelet because I really suck at making eggs. I really suck at making eggs of all types. Besides, the only egg that I'm good at making is, we have this, the toaster that we have. It's got a function on the side to make the steam poach eggs. It's got like an extra egg maker on the side. So that is like the only time that I know how to make eggs is using that. Like it comes with the little measuring cup just designed for the egg maker. And it tells you how much water to add for the soft, medium, or hard poached eggs. But I always choose medium because when I choose the soft poached eggs, when you try to take it out of the tray, it always makes the egg yolk break and it always makes it go everywhere. So I always try to use medium. There's the, some of the egg. Now that just really makes me want to crave Denny's now. When was the last time we went to Denny's, Matthew? Because with Denny's, every time when we go to Denny's, it's like one of those restaurants. I look at the whole menu and then I order the same thing again. Because it is one of the only restaurants that I know of that sells it. I really, really like their country fried steak. That is one of my favorites. I really like the country fried steak. So, if you guys like Denny's as well, let me know in the comments below what you like to get at Denny's. Like, I don't know about you guys, like, wherever you guys are from. The Denny's that is near us that I know of, it is like a 24 hours open restaurant. And in Calgary, I do not know much of other restaurants that are open 24 hours besides the drive-thru at McDonald's. But I always feel sorry for them, you know? It's like, seriously, are we that, like, in the modern 21st century like that? It's like, people should just go home and sleep. Like, seriously, why would you need to eat anything at 1 a.m. or 2 a.m. in the morning? Like, seriously. I would rather be in bed at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., wouldn't you? And what I remember from the last time that we went to Denny's is that I think they are one of those type of restaurant that you can order anything anytime. It's like you can order burgers and stuff at 9 a.m. in the morning or whatever. You can order anything on the menu. Because I know a lot of other sit-down restaurants, they have a certain time limit for certain parts of their menu. Later today, I want to do another mukbang video with you guys. I want to do, it's going to be a busy video day. I want to do a mukbang video with you guys, and, I want to do a chips mukbang video. I want to do one with the crunchy noises, the chips. Because, I've always avoided that brand because it's always been a little bit pricey in the world of chips compared to all the other chips brands out there. But then I finally gave in and I tried a flavor of the chips. It is those kettle cooked chips. Oh my gosh, those are to die for. So I'm going to be very excited to be doing some opening bag of the chips and to do a mukbang video with you guys on chips. And I know our dog Ebo would be going nuts when he's going to hear the crunchy noises. And he thinks the chips will be for him, but no, we cannot, because I only feed him the plain potato chips, the plain ones, because the other flavors can be dangerous for dogs and pets. So I just feed him the plain chips. And sometimes when we are having some bread or something, he whines for the bread too, and we feed him some plain bread. I think our doggy likes to have bread more than anything else though. And then in the world of the doggy treats, the stuff that we are supposed to give doggies, he really, really likes those bacon strips, those bacon strips that you see at the stores, like the ones for dogs. He goes nuts for those. Maybe one of these days I'm gonna do a demo video for you guys and show how crazy he goes for the snacks. Maybe I'm gonna do a doggy mukbang video. No, not really. That's not the way we feed Ebo. We just, pour a bowl of the doggy food for his bowl, and then he just goes whenever he likes to eat it, and then we just refill it when the bowl is empty. I know other people feeds pets different ways, like some people feeds the pets like with the different times and stuff, like the human, like they get breakfast, lunch, and dinner. But sometimes our doggy can, he can last a few days without finishing that bowl of doggy food.
I think it depends on what other treats you spoil him with.
Whatever. Show you guys the bacon. Bacon, bacon! Would you know if there's any difference? Cause they sell the thick cut bacon. Is there any difference with those?
You get less in the package.
No, but do you know if there's any difference in taste or whatever?
More bacon in every bite. That's basically it.
Mm. So what are you guys eating for breakfast today? Or are you having breakfast for dinner with me today? Mmm, bacon. So talking about bacon, I was watching one of Victoria Pikin's mukbang video a few videos ago. And they were making these wraps or something, and they had one piece of bacon left on the plate. I'm like, I want it. I want to reach through the screen. I want to get it. I was like, come on. I was like, come on. There's one piece of bacon left. Eat it. If you don't want to eat it, I'll eat it. Yeah. Tea. So, hopefully you guys will be having a lovely Sunday today, whatever you did. Hope it was a good one. Yeah, so today there's not going to be much stuff for me to do today. I just got a load of laundry to do. And possibly another load of dishes. Like, oh my gosh, like, our dishes lately has been going through crazy cycles this last little while. It's like, oh my gosh, because I think we have been eating more at home lately, that's why. So, yeah. And for dinner tonight, I am actually excited about the dinner tonight because I am trying out a new recipe. Ooh. There was still some tea halfway through down here. And so, yeah. So hope you guys will have a lovely Sunday. Thank you for tuning in for breakfast with me today. And welcome to my new subscribers. Don't forget I got a mukbang video playlist. And I got a playlist of all my other older videos. And I'll see you guys again soon.